Hey, it is Rich, and before you say anything, I know it's been a while since I've posted a vlog. I've been trying to keep my crafting business afloat since lockdown restrictions eased, which means I've had less time on my hands to dedicate to paranormal tedium. Any time away from the business, though, has not been idle time. To that end, and before we start this vid proper, I'd like to announce that Paranormal Tedium now has a Patreon page. This is purely for support donations only. There's no multi-tier benefits thingy, and nothing important will be hidden behind a paywall. Although we may give Patreon supporters early access to vids and early notice of live streams. I'm sure there'll be the odd other perk vid thrown in there too. So if you want to support us further and donate to the cause on Patreon, then that would be greatly appreciated. If you don't, then that's cool too. We love you all the same. Also, we've set up some merch storefronts on Spreadshop. As you can see, we've set up two storefronts, one for the UK and Europe, and the other for USA, Canada, and Australia. But if you click either link, you can scroll to the bottom of the store homepage and select your nearest country from the drop-down options in the footer. This means you won't be overpaying for shipping. It's mainly t-shirts and the odd hoodie for now, but if there's anything, item or design wise, you'd like us to consider, then please let us know, either in the comments on any of our vids, or message us directly on Messenger via our Facebook page. Links are in the vid description. Until we reach 1,000 subscribers, we don't have access to a community tab here on YouTube. So until that time, as we do reach 1,000 subs, all our updates are on our aforementioned Facebook page or as a Patreon post. Right, let's get to it. How would you define the word skeptic? And what do you think it means to be a skeptic? What the word means to people appears to have varied quite a bit over its approximate 2,500 year period of use. Today, it seems to mean anyone who is instantly dismissive, a hardcore non-believer, and or someone who criticises. And admittedly, some proclaimed sceptics do present in this fashion. At its core, the true meaning of a sceptic is one who questions. But the best definition that I've found, and one that I think resonates most with the paranormal tedium ethos, is by Miguel de Unamuno. Sorry if I've completely twatting butchered that pronunciation. In his 1924 work, Essays and Soliloquies, it goes like this. A sceptic, and I'm paraphrasing here, does not mean one who doubts, but one who investigates and researches, as opposed to one who asserts and thinks that they have found. Both sides of the paranormal fence would do well to heed this. When it comes to the paranormal, excluding the entertainers and the fakers, there's an extreme polarization of views. On the one hand, you have the true believers, and to them, ghosts are most definitely real. On the other, you have the out-and-out skeptics, and to them, ghosts most definitely cannot be real. If you ask both sides to describe the other, chances are the one phrase that would most likely to come out from both sides is closed-minded. And I would tend to agree with that perception. Don't know what I was doing there. Oops. And I would tend to agree with that perception. From where I'm sitting, both sides are extremely closed-minded, to the point now where it's gotten so bad that should anyone dare to tread the murky middle ground, they've taken to using the term open skeptic. Like good old Dan over at World of Mr. Grey. Well, I say old, Dan's probably 10 to 15 years younger than I am, but anyway, you see what I'm getting at. The trouble with each side, again, from where I'm sitting, is that their arguments and narratives only ever appeal to like-minded people. To coin a phrase, they're literally preaching to the converted. Neither side will ever win over the opposition due to how they go about presenting their respective arguments and evidence. You'll never see any of the ghost hunting community reading publications like Skeptical Inquirer. Nor will you see skeptics being won over by the compelling evidence presented in episodes of Ghost Adventures and the like. If we're ever going to get to the bottom of whether ghosts are real or not, we need to come together and discuss it without it all ending up in a catfight. In-depth research and controlled experimentation needs to be done, which is where we hope that paranormal tedium comes in. But, and this is a huge fucking but, whichever way it goes, both sides would have to be willing to admit to the possibility that they may be twatting wrong. But what do you think? Do you consider yourself a skeptic? And if so, how do you define the word? Please leave your thoughts and comments below. If you're new here, then please consider subscribing to the channel. And remember to click the bell icon. I don't do these types of vid that regularly. It's usually when I've got something on my mind. But there are other vids for you to check out. If you like them, tell everyone you know about us, which will help us to get to our next milestone. Speaking of liking vids, please give this one a thumbs up. This will show the YouTube algorithm that it's something worth promoting. This small act of kindness from you helps the channel out a lot. Also, remember the Facebook page, which I mentioned earlier, where you'll find more Paranormal Tedium mayhem. And we have a Facebook group, Paranormal Truth. This is where you can come discuss the current state of the paranormal community with us. Before I go, some final words by one Benjamin Jowett from his contribution to the 1860 works, Essays and Reviews, which I think applies nicely to the entire ghosting community. There is one word of caution, however, to be given to those who renounce inquiry. That is, they cannot retain the right to condemn inquirers. Thanks for watching. Okay, that's it. Stop.